Before we start, I'd like to greet Dr. Sirat. Is it right if Sirat or Serat?
Sirat.
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 Sirat. Okay, thank you. Okay. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. All Indonesian lectures, Indonesian English lectures all over Indonesia. Thank you for joining us tonight. I'd like to welcome Bapak Dr. Daniel Ginting as the President of IEA, Indonesian English Lecture Association. Bapak, good evening, Pak. Bapak Fahmi as the Vice President of IEA. And all board members and dear lecturers. I'd like to welcome our distinguished speakers, Dr. Sirat, Dr. Fatima Sirat. Thank you, Ibu Fatima. It's a great honor for us for your willingness to present and share your thoughtful insight to us, Indonesian lecture here. Good evening, Dr. Sirat.
Thank you very much, Andini. And thank you very much to Daniel and Venny, who collaborated and who honored me to get a chance to interact with the lecturers in Indonesia. And I hope we share the same teaching context, because both of us are the developing countries and we have almost the similar conditions over here in Pakistan and there in Indonesia. And the things that we will talk about here would be applicable to your settings as well as to my settings.
Okay. Based on our agenda for tonight, first inauguration of IEA, Indonesian English Lecture Associations, will be four sessions. The first session is for Bapak Fahmi, who will introduce the logo of introduce and explain the logo of IEA. And then the next session will be for Bapak Dr. Daniel Ginting, who will introduce the IEA board member and initially officially our association. And the third that we are waiting for is the professional development by sharing knowledge from Ibu Fatima. And the last session is about IEA programs. It's about discussion and asking for members' voices. To begin our seminars of first and our first inaugurations, we'd like audience to stand up and sing our Indonesian national anthem, Indonesia Raya. Please stand up. Pak Ridan. Indonesia.
Thank you. You may have a seat.
Without any further ado, I'd like to welcome Bapak Fahmi to introduce the AILA logo. Bapak Fahmi, please.
Okay, thank you very much, Bu Andini. Okay, tak share dulu. Is it clear?
Yes. As a crystal clear.
Okay, good evening, all the members and also the Bu Fatima and Pak Ginting as the president of AILA. And this is our first international webinar and also the inaugurations of AILA, Indonesians English Lecturers Associations. Okay, in this session, I just introduce the AILA shortly and also the launch of the AILA logo. Okay, the inaugurations of Indonesian English Lecturers Associations or AILA here is actually is intended to accommodate all the English lecturers in Indonesia, and not to mention also to engage the international lecturers. Okay. For the one who never heard about the AILA or recently heard about AILA, and the questions will be, what is AILA? So the AILA stands for Indonesian English Lecturers or Associations. It is a non-profit association where the Indonesian English lecturers gather, share, and collaborate through some academic programs and activities. And what are the AILA's programs and activities in general? So this is the programs that in general, or the outline or the headline of the programs in AILA. The first is the teaching to support the teachings, and the second is research, and the third is our program is community service. So it is a three dharma in Indonesia. And how about the activities that related to the program? The first is collaboration. The second is national and international webinar, research paper analysis, group sharing, training, managing, learning, reviewing, and gathering. And maybe we have a lot of the activities that relate to the program, related to Tri Dharma, and related to our national event and international event. And this is just the general activities or program in AILA started from this inauguration. And could you tell me more about AILA? AILA was initiated by several initiators. This is what I have been found in our forum, in English Lecturers Forum. The first is Lola, Bu Fanny, Mr. Ginting, Andini, Ms. Nining, and other AILA members who support the inaugurations of the Indonesian English Lecturers Association. And AILA was inaugurated on Friday, the 1st January 2021, and it is the new year. And I wish, and I say how this ILA was initiated to support all of the members and to support all the lecturers in Indonesia, and not to mention another international lecturers. And I also say Happy New Year for all the members and all the lecturers here in this new year. We have a gift to hold an international webinar that will be presented by Bu Fatima, Miss Fatima from Pakistan. And it was established to facilitate and accommodate the any English lecturers through several academic programs which can support their development of teaching, research, and community service. In this case, is Tri Dharma, to the support the lecturers' development to keeping their Tri Dharma, or for have contribute to our our country through Tri Dharma, especially in education. And this is the main of my presentation, is the launch of the ELA logo. So this is the first design of the second design of our association, Indonesian English Lecturers Association. The first is the letter E here means English, and the letter L represent the lecturers, and the third is the letter A, association, and the letter E is Indonesian. So ELA stand for is English Lecturers as a Indonesian Lecture English Lecturers Association. And how about the years here? 2021 is the inaugurations of ELA, and the small circle here means the organizers. The second is medium circle, is the members, and the lastly is the large circle, is the national and international. It means that the scope of the ELA is not only in the national, but also to engage other lecturers from other country, of course, Asia and also America and also another country that would be interested in joining ELA. And the LIPS means here is diversity, and the second is people, it's mean the unity. It's been the unity of all of us, which has a different background. And a book here means intellectual and moral. And there are three bars here, the first bar, second bar, and the third bar. The first, it's represent the three dharma in Indonesia. The first bar is teaching, and the second bar is research, and the third bar is community service. And this is the another logos of ELA, and of course it has different functions. What we would like do here is to not only to introduce ELA, but also to spread about ELA and its benefit to another lecturer in Indonesia and also the another lecturers in other country. And the first logos is represent for example, the certificate, for the blogs, for the Instagram, and another poster and another functions. And of course, it will represent the strength of the ELA Association. And this is the first chapter, because this is the integrations of Ella. This is the first chapter of our story in Ella. So we create the history here is about the Ella, the introduction to Ella, Indonesian English Lecturers Associations. And hopefully we also create another sheet, a chapter for Ella for the another event. For example, the nationals or international webinar or collections research or another collaborations, I mean. So this is the ELA integrations of ELA, and welcome to ELA for the members. Okay, thank you very much, Bu Andini.
Thank you, Bapak Fahmi, for a wonderful introduction. Now we'd like to move on to our second agenda. That is the opening of ELA officially by the president of ELA, Bapak Daniel Ginting.
Thank you very
Bapak
much.
Bapak Daniel Ginting. Andina.
Okay, Gini. Thank you. Can you hear my voice?
Yes, really.
Okay. Okay. Friends from IT Division, could you help me with the PowerPoint? Okay. Could you share? Okay, Marida, thank you very much. Okay, so good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Daniel Ginting. I'm so thrilled to meet all of you at this opportunity. Thank you for joining this event. Thanks all ELA committees for making this event possible. Just recently, we got sad news that Bapak Dr. Kiai Haji Safruddin Amir, the head of SDIE, Syamsul Ulum Gunung Puyuh Sukabumi, passed away. So I'd like to express my sincere condolences, and the family will be in my prayer and be strong. So, next slide. So special thanks go to my colleague, Fatima Sirat. She is currently a professor teaching at Rawalpindi Women University, Pakistan. She is one of the best e-teachers because of her amazing academic achievement in such a challenging e-teacher online program in 2010, maybe. Yeah? She was once invited by the US Embassy to attend teacher professional development program in the University of Maryland in 2011. She became the representative of Pakistan. There were about 26 of us at that time. And this is the picture where Fatima and I met. So this is, the picture was taken in 2011, and there were 26 of us from different countries. And we were in the Department of State at that time, yeah, Fatima. Is that right, Fatima?
Yeah, I remember. And then you were good at collecting memories and retaining them also.
So absolutely.
Look at the picture.
So thank you, Fatima. Because of her generosity and kindness, she's willing to be with us today to become the keynote speaker at the first ELA webinar. So thanks a lot, Fatima. Ladies and gentlemen, today
Daniel, I would
is...
like to add something.
Oh, do you want to say something? Okay, go ahead. Do you want to say something, Fatima? Yeah? Okay, that's fine. So today is January, you know, January the 1st, right? The January the 1st, 2021, all right? And Happy New Year to all of you. Yeah. It is the first day of the year that marks a new spirit, a new hope, and bright dreams for the future. And for that reason, Ayla board members are so determined to make this date as a moment of inauguration for Ayla, which was previously called Ella. So Ayla, just like what Fahmi said to us, stands for Indonesian English Lecturers Association. It is a new association. It was just born. It's born because the members have shared the same vision. Everyone wants to make Ayla a home for them. Teachers and lecturers teaching English where they develop themselves, empower themselves with teaching skills, research, and community service. And we do that through a variety of academic and collaborative activities. Again, so care, solidarity, and collaboration are the keywords for Ayla. Next slide, please. Some academic programs like seminars, research, collaboration, community service have been scheduled actually in 2021. It is hoped that these activities are impactful for the members, for all of us. Impactful means bringing benefit, making changes. Changes can be seen from how we perform. For example, in the past, we might be satisfied with our comfort zone. Now we are challenged to raise our performance. In the past, we might be sort of reluctant to write research articles or make books. Now we begin to be challenged to initiate ideas and start writing. And we realize that this could only happen if we help each other, collaborate with friends, colleagues, etc. However, please note that not all of these answers, your expectation, our expectation can be found in Ayla. But there are always possibilities that Ayla can help us to achieve this expectation. Ayla is still new and it has a lot of things to learn. However, in the spirit of the new year, Ayla welcomes this era that brings with a message of hope. It is an opportunity to reinvent ourselves, but only if we have the strength to keep moving forward. This year, come up with one thing that Ayla is willing to do, and just do it. Just take one small step today in the right direction. Next slide. As the ancient Chinese philosopher Lao Tzu reminds us, the journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step. So ladies and gentlemen, finally, with the grace of Almighty God, as the chairman of Ayla, I'd like to declare that on January the 1st, 2021, Indonesian English Lecturers Association is officially inaugurated. Thank you very much. I give it back to Andini.
Okay. Thank you for the wonderful speech, Bapak Ginting. Audience, please give a big applause for the declaration of Ayla by Pak Daniel Ginting. Okay, thank you so much. Now we move to our main agenda. That is the one that is waiting for all of us who are thirsty and hunger to get new knowledge and information, certification from people from other countries, especially from developing countries, which share the same situation, the same challenges, and the same situation. In the early days of the COVID-19 pandemic, schools and other educational establishments were forced to shift their teaching online, in many cases without advance warning or training for educators. Now that's been a couple of months, teacher and student are getting into rhythm of teaching and learning from home. And it's a great time to take a look at some new teaching techniques, especially ones that work well with distance learning. One example is through flipped learning. Even though we have tried to use blended learning or some maybe use flipped learning, we may encounter some hardships and still confused to find the right pattern. That's therefore, let's get some inside secrets for somebody who's been there. Would you please welcome Dr. Sirat? Before we start, Dr. Sirat, before we start, I'd like to introduce Dr. Sirat to all members of AIRA.
Okay, do you want me to introduce myself to the members?
Yeah, but can you show the profile? Okay, Dr. Sirat, Fatima Sirat is an assistant professor at the Department of English at Rawalpindi Women University, Pakistan. She's also a training consultant at British Council of Pakistan and also the author of modules of teaching English language skill for higher education Pakistan. So it's really, we can partners with Ibu Fatima in the future. As a core project of Open University UK and Higher Education Commission Pakistan. For the education, she graduated from Master of Philosophy, English Linguistics, CELTA from Cambridge University, and Diploma TEFL Allama Iqbal Open University, IOM, Pakistan. That is a short introduction of Dr. Sirat. Okay, please welcome again Dr. Sirat. Ibu Fatima?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, I'm Fatima. So, but I just want to talk with you.
Hello?
Hello?
Yes. We cannot see your slide.
Okay, thank you. Just a minute. I think the person.
Yeah, it's, we can see it now.
So I can just
Bu Fatima?
Hello?
Yeah. It's not really clear with the voice.
Okay, let's just watch it in the voice. Just a minute, please. Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Okay, that's good. So it's a great honor for me to be a part of Indonesian English Language Association at their inauguration. And I probably am the first speaker of this association and it's of the first event of this association. So it's a great honor for me and I'm looking forward to collaborate with this association in future as well. For research purposes, for more training and things like that. Okay. So if my voice is clear to everyone, I can start my presentation.
Yes, it's clear. Good.
Okay, thank you, Renee. Okay, so today we'll talk about flipped classroom in general. what the technique of flipped classroom is. Then we look at the theoretical background or you can say theoretical connections of flipped classroom, that how it is connected to the other teaching theories and methodologies, etc. And then we'll particularly focus at developing English as a second language, developing English as a second language through flipped classroom. What techniques we can use, what activities we can do. Now, if you look at this picture, take 2 minutes and just read what is written on the picture, and then I will explain it to you.
It is interesting. So the flipped classroom is upside down.
Yeah, it's also called reverse classroom. It is also called reverse classroom, or you can say inverted classroom. That's why it's upside down. And why it is called reverse, or you can say inverted classroom, because in flipped classroom, the students, they do classwork at home and homework to school or in the class. Now, and these are the different points that we will cover in the later slides. This is just a, you can say, sort of mapping of the things that we will discuss today. Now, so what is flipped classroom? It was introduced by Jonathan Bergman and Oren Sams in 20s. And it is a mode of blended learning. And I hope you are familiar with blended learning, where technology is involved in learning, because this is the age of computers, internet, and there is a lot of material available on internet in form of videos, podcasts, etc., etc. So the teachers, instead of putting all the effort by themselves, they just need to manage their teaching. They can take help from these already, you can say, made up and available resources from internet, and they can effectively use it in their teaching, so that they could save their energy. Instead of just lecturing and lecturing and lecturing, they can make their teaching interesting, as well as they can spend more time, they can to monitor and guide the students to develop their skills themselves. Okay, so this flipped classroom is a mode of blended learning. Why? Because it has some sessions online where the students, they watch videos, video lectures, YouTube videos, and other resources that were mentioned on the slide, previous slide. They can use that at home, and in class, they can have face-to-face interaction. They can have discussions, and they can have more challenging tasks like experiments, etc., etc. Flipped classroom is a pedagogical approach in which the conventional notion of classroom-based learning is inverted. As Daniel said, that this is a reverse classroom. And how it is inverted? In traditional classroom, the students, they do, the teachers, they give lectures to them. They listen to the teachers, they take notes, and then they go back home and they do detailed questions at home. Fine. And they do creative tasks at home. This is the traditional classroom. Now, when they are doing those more challenging and creative tasks, they can make mistakes. Fine. So the teacher's work is increased to evaluate them, to assess them, and to mark them and score them. Now, in flipped classroom, the students, they listen to the lectures to get the basic concepts, to get the basic information related to different things. And when they come to the class, they do more challenging and creative tasks in the supervision of the teacher, so that they get more guidance from the teacher and they produce quality work and they perform better. So as I already said that in, sorry, Andini, do you want to say something?
No, I'm listening.
Okay, so here the classwork is done at home and homework is done in class. Now looking at the key features of flipped classroom. Flipped classroom provides more individual learning space. Now, how does it provide more individual learning space is that when the teacher shares videos and other like short activities to the students, he can share different resources and links where the students can practice and gather information from. So the students, they can watch those videos, they can do those practice activities by their own at their own time, whensoever they feel convenient. Many a times what happens is, let's say it is the last period of the day and it's English class. So the students, they are just in a hurry to leave the institution, or they are in a sleeping mode, not at all active to participate in any activity. So if the teacher shares some material and resources for the student, so whensoever they feel comfortable, they can watch those videos, they can gather points from those resources. Then another key feature of flipped classroom is interactive learning environment. In traditional classrooms, the teacher comes to the class, delivers a lecture, provides all type of, rather I would say, transmit the knowledge to the students and goes back. There is no interaction between teacher and student, no interaction between students and students. Many a times, till the end of the semester, teacher even does not know the name of all the students, and even students do not know each other. So it gives opportunity for more interactive learning, where the students can ask questions from the teacher do ask questions from the students. The students, they participate in discussions and they discuss different problems with each other for problem solving activities. They work in groups and they learn from each other. Another key feature of flipped classroom is that the students, they get more personal feedback and assistance from the teacher. Right? So when the teacher gives lectures or dictates different answers of the questions to the students or assigns activities, so the student, the teacher in the limited class of time cannot provide feedback to all the students. But through flipped classroom, when the students have done the basic activities at home, so when they come to the classroom, the teacher can give more challenging activities and he can monitor all the students when they're participating in group work, and he can also look at their work. So he saves the time of the lecture to monitor students' performance when they are actually doing their activity. Now, if you look at the pedagogical and theoretical connections of flipped classroom, the theoretical basis of the flipped classroom lie in constructivist ideology and active learning theory. Fine. So constructive ideology says that the students or the learners, they construct their knowledge with the more knowledge, with the help of more knowledgeable others. So in every student, there is every student faces a zone of proximal development, that is ZPD, where they have some knowledge and they are stuck at a certain point of time. So they know something and there is something that is unknown to them that they want to know. So with the help of more knowledgeable other, they can learn what they do not know. In case of flipped classroom, this more knowledgeable other is not only the teacher. It can be the other student. It can be the video lectures. It can be the internet sources and the other reading materials that the teacher provides them for their assistance or for their learning at home, fine. And when they participate in group discussions, group activities, or when they interact with the teacher in the classroom, then they can get that knowledge from the teacher, from the other students. And from the online sources also. Then how is it connected to active learning theory? Is active learning theory, that is, linked to Jerome Bruner, who presented this theory. So according to active learning theory, learning is an active process. And learners construct their knowledge based on the past knowledge. So when the students or the learners, instead of just listening to the teacher passively, when they listen to the teacher at home, they watch videos, they do practice exercises at home. And when they come to the class, they ask questions from the teacher. They participate in discussions. They write things by themselves. They do experiments. Fine. And they, for example, in an English class, they role play. They interview each other. They write argumentative essays in supervision of the teacher. So they are actually participating. Instead of teacher telling them the rules of writing an argumentative essay, they themselves are writing an essay based on certain topic or certain issue that they watched yesterday at home. Fine. And now they are giving their opinion on that. They're developing their argument on that. So they are more active, right? And they take the responsibility of their learning. Now, a different methodologies that are used in flipped classroom. It is group discussion, right? And the group discussion is the simpler form of flipped learning, where the learners are peer-assisted. Peer-assisted means they take help from you. Sometimes you have above average, below average students in your class. So, doing group discussions, you can engage teaching learners with sharp or more intelligent more sharp students so that sometimes the students are hesitant to ask the teacher because they think the teacher may snub them. Right? I'm not the best person, but the people students. So during group discussions, they can learn from each other. They can assist each other. Then experimentation in science classes is more complex form of flipped learning. Problem-based learning, where students, they watch all the videos of certain experiments at home, they learn the phenomenon or concept at home, and when they come to the class, they actually experiment what they have learned, right? But that is more advanced. In language classes, it is comparatively easy to manage flipped classrooms. Then there can be pair reading. Pair reading is another form of flipped learning where you give half the passage to one student and half the passage to the other student. And so whatsoever they have read, first person tells what he has said about the topic and the other person tells what he has said, and then they share the information with each other and they get complete information. Fine, instead of each student reading the whole passage, you can divide different parts or different extracts from the passage among different students, and it in shorter time, and then they share their points with each other and get complete knowledge. It can also be used in mathematical classes, and it is like active learning is a key instruction method that engages students in learning process. Fine. Now this was just a little background of flipped classroom. So flipped classroom is based on four pillars, fine, where every letter stands for something. As AILA stands for Indonesian English Language Association. So similarly, FLIP also stands for F for flexible environment, L for learning culture, I for intentional content, and T for professional education. Now, flexible environment. How does it provide or require flexible environment is that teachers, they share lectures, those can be YouTube lectures or teachers on recorded lectures. And the teachers can record their own lectures and share podcasts with students, and they can download some lectures from YouTube and they can share it with their students. So they can use software like Screencast kind, etc., to use already available video lectures for them. They're very good video lectures on YouTube that teachers easily use for their flipped classrooms. Now, so how does it provide flexible environment is that students can watch those video lectures or they can read those texts whatsoever time that is suitable or feasible for them. Instead of just learning it within that, you can say 1 hour of the class. Even maybe when they are lying in their bed, right, because of cold weather, they can read that or they can watch that video. Then it is learning culture. It is a shift in the learning culture. This classroom is a shift in the learning culture in a way that the learning from, it is shift from teaching to learning. The classrooms are no more teacher-centered, rather they are learner-centered. Where teacher, in traditional classrooms, they are teacher-centered. Where teacher is talking on the frame, teacher is talking in the knowledge, whereas in flipped classrooms, it is learner-centered. Where learners are participating in activities, they are participating in learning, and they're also getting restricted to the learner. If they do not watch videos, if they do not watch, then they are responsible for it. Right? Okay, then intentional content is that it does not mean that teacher does not have to follow the course outline. He has to make the lessons or prepare the lessons or select the videos or record videos very thoughtfully. He has to see what he actually wants his learner to learn. What skills does he want to develop in his lessons? So he has to make sure that whatsoever material he shares with the students is in his
Dr. Sirat, sorry, your yes, voice yes. is, you know,
okay, this stable
up. Yeah.
Okay, up and, yeah. Okay, so P is for professional educator. So it is like a flip. Classroom requires professional attitude and professional skills both. The teacher should be familiar with the updated resources. The teacher should be research oriented so that he could make or she could make a research and prepare good resources for his or her students. Okay, Andini, is it clear now? Is my voice clear now?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. Now, coming to the point or the focal point that is developing ESL through flipped classroom. Now, English is a second language in many developing countries like Pakistan, Indonesia, and there are so many other countries. English is the medium of instruction and education, and English is taught as a subject. That means that the students, they are taught the content. For example, they are taught grammatical rules. They are taught what reading comprehension is. Right? Instead of or developing their skills of reading, they are just taught what is skimming, what is scanning, etc., etc. So English is taught as a subject, not as a language. Students' English language skills are quite poor in almost all the developing countries, though English is the second language for them. Though they read or all the books, particularly at higher education level in English, fine, they have to take the exam in English, still their English language is really poor. Teacher-centered classroom is a big factor for poor English language skills of students, because for 1 hour or 1.5 hours, they are just listening to teach and they do not have any opportunity to express themselves to teach. And though the learners of the current age or current time, this is the time of technology, so learners, though they are more technology savvy, are less active. Right? They know technology that teachers. They can access different resources, but they get less ability to explore resources for their learning. They do it by their own, but they cannot do it in a systematic way as the teacher guides them to do. So if it engages them in flipped classroom, then the teacher will manage this technology or technical resources more systematic and more effectively for their students. There is an interesting point about the importance of English. That is by Mahil in 2011. He said, English is an absolutely critical subject in curriculum. Not only does it help young people learn from themselves and the world, it explores culture, creativity, and critical thinking, but it also enables fine. So if the students, particularly at higher education level, where the lecturers teach at colleges and in universities, so the students, they need English to study every subject in their curriculum. If they can understand English, if they can write good English, if they can speak good English, then they can excel in all the subjects, because it gives them chance to explore the world, to engage in learning, and to be creative, and to be think critically. Now, developing ESL to flipped classroom. So what do the how does the flipped classroom help in developing ESL? It modifies teaching style learning style of the pupils to developing critical thinking of students for better students and understanding. So in a minute I will talk about how you can develop critical thinking among students and how you can develop their understanding of text. What activities do you do to do so? The learners, they get more time for writing than language. So the learners learn grammatical rules and rarely get the chance to use that grammar in practical life. Fine. They do not know how to use adjectives in their day-to-day conversation. They do not know how to use adjectives. They just know what adjectives are, what the different types of adjectives are, etc., etc. So what are the so here, instead of learning those rules, the clauses are how to use the more creativity to make the writing more vivid, more colorful, and in style in their writing. Then students, they can benefit from flipped classroom by practicing speaking skills in face-to-face session to role play and interview, etc. And the teacher gives more personal space to struggling learners to manage their skills. If we could add activities that the students will do in class and outside the class, fine. So the homework is a flipped classroom. If you could see, this would be a total reverse of our traditional classroom. So in a flipped classroom for English as a second language, outside the class, the students will watch video lectures. That again, I would say, can be recorded by the teacher or can be downloaded from the YouTube. If they are downloaded from the YouTube, that is more beneficial for the students. Why? Because they get exposure to the native speakers, right? Because most of the recorded speakers on YouTube, they are recorded by the native speakers of English. So the students are all the time listening to their local English language. If they watch a video from YouTube where a European teacher is teaching English, who is native to English, so they will get more exposure to English language, its pronunciation, accent, and the language structures that are used in native, by the native speakers. So they will watch videos at home, and based on those videos, have question answering class. They do descriptive writing. For example, the teacher sent them a video of a particular place or of a tourist place. Ask watch the video and select two questions from that. And when the question starts, teacher asks to describe the place that they watched in the video. Right? So they can do descriptive writing in the class, where the teacher can write them how to use a then the teacher will take a movie to watch the truth and to provide the review of the movie to the class. The teacher will send them a recorded video about the use of parasympathy. When they come to the class, the teacher will download and ask them to convert it into parasympathy and write in form of a review. So the two responses will be review writing. Now, how to strategies of speech, and when it comes to the teacher, ask them to share the inferences from the text with each other. They discuss the information that they have read from a book, for example, as I said, which are concepts. The teacher can divide it up into text, and when they come back to the class, he asks them to sit in a group and share the points that. So in this way, in limited time, students can read smaller text forms, but can get more information. And then based on that information, you can ask them to write something. It can be some analytical or argumentative writing. For example, the teacher asks them about crisis or issue, current issue at home, and when they come to the class, they discuss opinion about that. Right? Then the learners, they can learn grammatical rules and examples for different courses and at home. And when they come to the class, they get knowledge of examples and support to bring writing style to their writing. For example, the teacher asks them to write a paragraph and use complex sentences in that paragraph. Right? When they have watched the video lecture about subordinate clauses at home, they have read about grammar, adjectives, different other parts of speech at home. And when they come to the class, they use that in their writing. Then the students can listen to different type of conversations by native speakers at home that are shared by the teacher. And when they come to the class, they do role play and where they use those, you can say, conversation structures like greetings and etc. How to express their liking and disliking. So the role play is the class. Okay. Then at home, they can do close-ended quizzes and practice exercises. They can do more.
Now, Dr. Sirat, can you? I'm sorry, Sintra. It's still, you know, up and down.
Sorry?
The voice is still up and down.
Sorry, I think because of the weather, the connection may not be stable.
Oh, okay.
Is it clear now?
Yes, but then, you know.
Okay, there is distortion again. Maybe.
Yeah, distortion.
Yeah. Okay, so then if we talk about advantages of flipped learning, so Andini, whenever there is distortion, please do inform me.
Yes, right? Thank you.
So that I could manage for that. Okay, so what are the advantages of flipped learning? Right? The lessons and contents are more accessible and students take responsibility of their learning. Why? Because the teacher shares the material, and in the next face-to-face session, the activities will be based on that video lecture or material that the teacher has shared to do at home. So if it is the responsibility of the students to do that before coming to the class, right? So they will be more responsible. They will take responsibility of their learning. Then increasing interaction between teachers, students, and students and students. As I said, that lectures would be shared through online classes, or you can say through video lectures in their classrooms, or in their email, etc. So when they come to the class, they participate in discussions, they participate in question answers. So they interact with their teachers, they interact with each other. Then it promotes student-centered learning and collaboration, more control of students. By this, students have more time with technology. So the students, they like time with technology. So instead of wasting their time on the other activities, they will watch learning-related videos, find content-related videos, find, and they will do it for some purpose, for some academic purpose. They will get more time for authentic research. The teachers will get more time for research with students when they will monitor what the students are doing. Then she will make them to participate in different activities. Their problems and what can be done to solve those problems. The teachers can make more research on students. Fine? That is action research. So they can apply different techniques and see their results. Then it also enables flexible instructions and connects with individual needs of students. Fine? Because the teacher will be able to identify that which student needs more support when she is monitoring them instead of giving lecture. Now the students are doing the work and the teacher is just monitoring and facilitating them. So the teacher will be able to recognize that which student needs more support from the teacher. So the teacher can arrange some extra activities or some extra videos or notes for that student, so that, or she can engage that struggling student with a sharper student so that he could also benefit from the class. Lectures can be reused and use of technology is flexible and appropriate with this student. So if the teacher has recorded a lecture or downloaded a good lecture about one language content once, she can use it for the other students also. Fine. So she can reuse her resources. And absent students will not miss anything. So the, usually when it is a face-to-face lecture in a traditional classroom where the teacher just gives lecture for 1 hour, so the absent students usually miss what the teacher taught in the class. So if it is flipped classroom and the teacher can share the lectures, recorded lectures with the students who are sitting at home, right? Now there are certain disadvantages of flipped learning also, particularly with for the countries like us. Technology issues, as there is distortion in voice, and the students are unable to access the links because of the poor connection, because of the electricity issues. Then organization of flipped classroom is a challenge. As I said in the beginning, that it requires professional attitude. It is for the professional educators. So it is not just saving teachers' energy. Sometimes it may require more energy from the teacher. But if you put your energy once, you can use it for future also. Sometimes maybe lack of motivation, because for the teacher, it seems a hassle to record the lectures for the students and then to deliver, to have face-to-face sessions also. Fine. So because of this extra, you can say, work, there may be lack of motivation, and it is not for every student, right? We can do it for some, you can say, students at higher education level or maybe in colleges, but it may be difficult for to manage it for very young learners, right?
and it relies on preparation and trust. So the teacher has to prepare, but he has to trust on the learners also that they will do this, these activities that they are required to do at home. Fine. And it is increase in time in front of screen instead of people in place. So obviously, they have to watch the videos at home, so they have to give more time to the screen. Teacher's comfort level with technology, it also depends on the teacher's comfort level with the screen also. Many traditional teachers, they are not used to technology and they are not ready to use technology as well. Some students and teachers prefer to, they think that they have good interaction with the students in face-to-face sessions instead of video lectures and etc. So they enjoy face-to-face sessions with the students more as compared to, so they prefer traditional setup instead of flipped classroom. That's all from my side. I hope I did not take longer than the required time.
No. Perfect.
Okay.
Okay, thank you, Dr. Sirat. There are some questions that have been written by participants tonight. There are 4 questions, actually.
Okay.
Yeah. The first.
Pak Ahmad, Bu Andini.
The first from Bu Rahmi first. Bu Rahmi asked, the flipped learning sounds like project-based learning. What is the difference?
Okay. Flipped classroom looks like project learning, you said. Mm-hmm. Project, okay. Flipped classroom is like, for example, you have, let's say, 12 teaching content, right? So for those content,
Ibu Fatima, hello? Ibu Fatima? Dr. Sirat, hello? Hello? Hello?
And we lose connection, Bu Andini.
Yeah. Hello? Okay, we're waiting for Ibu Fatima connection. Maybe some of the participants here can share, who has known about flipped classroom, may share the answer or the knowledge or experience.
I think Bu Nining knows this because Bu Nining has a research on this before, I guess.
No, Penny, I haven't done the research yet. I'm proposing, so I'm writing the proposal. So I think I'm not in the capacity of sharing this too much. I mean, but it's kind of, yeah, it's exactly like Dr. Sirat has explained to me, has clarified. I guess also in the chat box, Bu Penny also has clarified what flipped learning is. Yes, it's correct. So the class is flipped. That's all my proposal. So I don't want to talk much. It's not my capacity yet. Sorry.
Okay.
Yeah. But that is clear there. And the constraints, to face the constraints, I'm also dealing with that.
You try to connect. Dr. Sirat, hello? Oh, lose connection.
But based on the readings that I have ever passed through, yeah? So flipped learning is just like flipped. The activities is started from the house. So in the classroom, the teacher give achievable tasks, like give the students to complete, like let's say watching video or So at home, you watch this and you have to answer several questions based on the video. So the teacher will give guided questions. And the following meeting, they will discuss that in the classroom. In the engaged classrooms activities, like they have jigsaw groups. So they split the groups and then they change the groups again. So basically, flip learning is based on the social cognitive theory by Bandura, if you know that. So it's about how we have a active learning involving students as the center of the learning. So they create their own learning by connecting one to another as the, because they are the center of the process of learning. So social cognitive learning theory developed through the participations of the students, they develop their cognitions, something like that.
Hello? Hello?
Hello?
Yeah,
there hello?
Hello?
Fatima.
Hello, Bu Fatima?
Yeah, I'm back. Sorry, there was
something. Okay. Okay.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay. So I was explaining the difference between project learning and flipped classroom. Yes, project-based learning and flipped classroom. So I think project-based learning is flipped classroom. It has you can say a limited span as compared to project, because in project the learners, they have more independence to select the projects that they work on, find the work in teams. But flipped classroom is comparatively more controlled, where smaller tasks to the students, right? Every student in the class or every learner in the class has to watch the same video, do the same activity. And when they come to the class, they just role play and they just have discussions. And so it is for you can say for a limited time span also, and is more controlled and more guided by the teacher. Whereas project gives more independence and more autonomy to the learners, and they can select their topics, they can work by their own, they collaborate with each other more. But over here, they do collaborate, but they collaborate under the supervision of the teacher. Right? So this is more guided, more facilitated as compared to project-based learning.
Okay. Okay. Gimana, Ibu Rahmi? Is it clear now?
If it is like that, so it is different from the explanation from Bu Fanny. Bu Fanny said that before the lectures or the teachers explain the materials, students learn the materials. So. But from Dr. Sirat, it can be concluded that before asking students to learn themselves, the teacher or the lecturer gives explanation first about the contents or the materials. That's why I previously I thought that it looks like a project-based learning, because in project-based learning, the teacher or the lecturer is also explaining the material or content first before asking students to do the project or to do the or to learn the materials.
Okay, where the teacher explains them is basically in flipped classroom. The teacher does not explain in the class. The teacher sends recorded lectures to the students before coming to the class. So when they come to the class, they actually do challenging work. Whereas in project-based learning, as you perceive it, that the first student, the teacher introduces the content, teaches them about the content, and then the students, they do projects related to that content by themselves. So this is a sort of reverse, where the students, the teacher gives recorded lectures that they listen to before coming to the class, and when they come to the class, they do more challenging tasks and activities.
Okay. Now we move to another question from Bapak Ahmad Fauzan. It's very interesting question, since
You mentioned earlier about these advantages of flipped learning. The question are how to maintain the students' motivation in such a flipped classroom learning. The second one, would you please give us some tips and tricks and how to provide high instruction of English with low technologies in some areas with limited internet access?
Okay, so the first question is how to motivate the students for flipped learning.
Yeah.
Yes. So the idea is that, as I said, that if the teacher records the lecture herself or himself, and if all the time she just records the lecture and sends to the students, they will not be motivated, obviously. They would see that they can listen to the teacher in the class. Why to listen at to her at home? So if the teacher brings variety of things to share with the students that they do at home, for example, you can download videos from from YouTube that are from some other instructor. You can also share reading text sometimes. Sometimes for language classes, the teacher may share some video that is not related to the content directly. Rather, it is a movie, let's say. So the students, they watch the movie at home, and when they come to the class, they write about the characters. They describe the characters of the movie. Fine. They describe the different scenes in the movie. They talk about, or they interview each other, or take each other's opinion about the movie. So that would be a sort of, if the teacher shares variety of activities with the students that they do at home, then obviously their motivation level will increase. But if all the time teacher just records her own lecture about what is adjective and what is this and what is that, and ask them to do some creative activities in the class, obviously they will be less motivated. And the second question was related to technology issues.
Yes.
So in this age, almost all the students, they have smartphone and they use mobile data. If they do not have internet, but they have smartphones, so you can share it through Bluetooth or like infrared, or if they're using WhatsApp, so videos on WhatsApp, that they do not need any laptop or very hi-fi technology for that. They can watch them, they can read those short texts on their mobile phones even.
Okay. I think more question actually is still related. It's about...
Sorry, one more point, Andini. As you said, yes, that the flipped classroom is not synchronous mode of teaching. That if
sorry?
Is, I said it is not only the synchronous mode of teaching. If you're not connected at that time, you will not be able to do this. You can download and see it offline as well. So whensoever you have good internet connection, you can access that link.
Yeah, okay.
Okay. That's why I said that you can manage it in your own pace and time.
Okay, synchronous and asynchronous. It could be asynchronous.
It could be asynchronous. It is actually asynchronous.
Oh, okay. It is actually asynchronous. Okay. I think that's answer the question for Bapak Ahmad, that it is actually asynchronous. Asynchronous, I will explain bahasa Indonesia. Asynchronous means tidak pada waktunya, jadi bisa di-download. And use anytime.
Yes, they can download, or whenever they have good internet connection, they just click on the link and watch the video.
Okay. I think this is the last question, but very interesting issue. I don't know whether in Pakistan we share the same issue. It's about learning awareness. Student awareness in learning.
Awareness about technology?
No. How it's really difficult. Yes, it's really related to motivation actually. How to build up student awareness in learning? You're lazy to learn. So how can we, for example, I just want to make it clear. We ask them to watch and to learn the material at home. Mm-hmm. In fact, students with low learning awareness wouldn't do that, and the next day they come to the class with nothing.
Okay, so if they do not come, if they come to the class with nothing, but when you engage them in group work, they will learn something from the other students. Okay. One thing. Second thing is you can shift the roles of the students. For example, if you divide them in groups, so not the same member talks every time about the topic. Right? You can change the roles. For example, next time you may ask the person who think is not watching those videos. So you can give him or her the responsibility to share the information with the other students. Right? Or you can ask the other students to ask questions from him or her. So this way, he would know that next time if he does not watch or if he does not learn, so he would not be able to do that. Right? Because in flipped classroom, one advantage is that they're not sitting as a whole class and the teacher is standing in one corner and looking at them. They're divided into smaller groups, sometimes pairs, sometimes groups of three, chairs, or maybe smaller groups. So they see that the teachers will monitor them and the teacher will know that who is learning and who is not learning. Right? So sometimes they can watch the videos when they know that the teacher will monitor them closely. The teacher can ask them questions, the students ask them questions. So this way, I think they and even if they not watch, when the others are participating in discussing, they will certainly learn from them.
Okay. I think we are. Is there any more question, Bapak Ibu?
I think we have a very wonderful presentation from Ibu Fatima. Thank you very much, Fatima, for presentation. Yeah. Give applause, everyone.
Thank you,
Ibu. Thank you, Dr. Sirat.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you, Ibu Fatima, for insightful explanation and knowledge about flipped learnings, and have explained all the questions clearly, I guess. Even I could understand what you said from all the questions. Thank you, Ibu Fatima.
Thank you very much, Andini, Benny, for your coordination, and Dr. Daniel, for inviting me to your association. And I would really appreciate collaboration in future as well. And whenever I am time, I'm ready to work in collaboration with Indonesian lecturers for research and for training and for sharing knowledge, etc.
Thank you so much. Thank you so
much.
Thank
you very much, Fatima. Stay healthy there in Pakistan.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Okay. That's all for wonderful explanation and wonderful sharing session from Ibu Fatima. I hope what she has presented will be amal jariah for Ibu Fatima in the life after.
Yeah. We call it Sadqah Jariyah.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Now we move to our four. Bu Fatima, you may stay here or you may leave the presentation, leave the meeting. It's okay. Or you may wait until our last session. It's okay. Okay. Now we move on to, thank you very much, Bu Fatima. We move on to our last session, that is the presentation of AILA programs. Now, I myself, we read the programs representing AILA board members. Pak IT, please. Okay, AILA program 2020. Actually, I'm not the one who made the program, but all divisions send the programs to me. And most of them based on the it also based on the result of the Google form that I sent you last time about which program or two programs that you think that you like to have in the future. Okay, next. Let's go to the program of research deficiency programs. Some programs, the first program is conducting collaborative research with AILA members. Second one, coaching clinic for writing international journal article from senior to junior lecturer. Okay, sorry, I haven't checked the spelling from the research deficient. Hold monthly forum komunikasi ilmiah. All member can be speaker, moderator, and committee. Coaching clinic or of research proposal or wait, miss. The box, apa ini? Research grant, book writing of English learning. Next. Okay, based on the Google Form, ini adalah hasil dari Google Form di mana Bapak Ibu voluntarily menyediakan waktunya untuk presentasi di forum komunikasi ilmiah pada bulan-bulan yang telah ditetapkan. Mungkin saya sedikit memberi apa ya, men-stressing bahwa yang akan dipresentasikan supaya Bapak Ibu mungkin tidak terlalu takut, misalnya takut bahwa harus hal-hal yang bersifat research. Bisa riset dalam pengertian masih bersifat planning. Saya ingin planning, jadi jangan dibawa terlalu serius, terlalu apa ya, mengerikan bahwa oh duh, saya harus research proposal. Alhamdulillah ketika pada bulan yang Bapak Ibu sendiri tulis itu research proposalnya sudah jadi dan ingin mendapatkan input dari teman-teman yang lain. Tetapi jika masih berupa wacana silahkan. Atau saya mau diseminasi hasil, silahkan. Hasil riset saya, silahkan pada kesempatan ini. Atau saya ingin mengajak, mau sharing knowledge tentang sesuatu pada bulan ini, silahkan. Jadi apapun selama itu bersifat ilmiah. Okay. Jadi Bapak-Ibu silahkan dilihat. Mungkin mengingat kembali bulan-bulan yang telah diisi oleh Bapak dan Ibu. Kita lihat bulan depan itu ada Bu Erlinda Syam, Bapak Katnawi, Bu Sylvia, Eli Hayati Nasution, Bu Hikmah Nur Agustina. Bu Hikmah Nur Agustina, it seems ready, salah satu mengisi tentang, kalau nggak salah ya, jurnal, kalau tidak salah saya. Oke, jadi di bulan ini setiap orang akan bisa menjadi moderator. Jadi moderator tidak mesti saya, akan bergantian dan akan kita propose di grup siapa yang ingin menjadi moderator, siapa yang akan menjadi speaker. Jadi diharapkan nanti akan dapat sertifikat yang akan berguna nanti untuk pengisian BKD. Oke, next. Kemudian pada teaching division programs, I think it initially planned by Pak Ginting with collaborative writing books and webinar. We have done once this year, KKNI syllabus sharing. Okay, mudah-mudahan masih KKNI ya. Lecturer exchange. Termasuk saya lihat salah satu lecturer exchange itu yang cukup bagus. Saran dari siapa ya? Bu Husnul kah? Kalau tidak salah yang dari Aceh. Di mana... dosen, misalnya saya mengajar mahasiswanya Bu Husnul atau Bu Rahmi. Nanti Bu Rahmi atau Pak Ginting ngajar mahasiswa saya. Salah satu sarannya seperti itu. Oke, student exchange, pertukaran pelajar. Bisa juga dalam pengertian misalnya menjadi reading buddy, speaking buddy. Itu juga salah satu contohnya. Oke. Kemudian, Jakat Guidance. Apa ini Jakat Guidance? Nanti kita dengar dari Teaching Division Jakat itu apa ya? Saya juga enggak tahu ini Jakat apa. Okay, next Pak. Mungkin nanti divisionnya akan menjelaskan apa itu Jakarta Guidance. Apa sih? Okay, next community service program yaitu mereviewing book panduan penelitian dan pengabdian. Kemudian ada PKM, program kreativitas mahasiswa. I have no idea about this. Nanti kalau ada diskusi setelah ini silakan tanya ke divisinya masing-masing. Seminar or training for English teacher, kemudian making anthology of folk stories from all over area Indonesia using English. Jadi membuat kumpulan cerita rakyat dari seluruh Indonesia dan di bahasa Inggris kan. Ya. Oke, okay, next. IT and documentation. Oke, okay, IT sudah bergerak. Sudah kelihatan pada kesempatan ini. Thank you, team IT, for preparing Google Form for attendance and backup data of attendance. Kemudian preparing certificates of AILA activities, designing flyers and poster of AILA activities. Itu akan sangat capek banget IT karena tiap bulan ada meeting ya. Untung IT-nya muda-muda semua. Kalau kayak saya udah bengek-bengek kali tiap bulan. Menjadi host tiap bulan bayangin ya atau co-host online meeting. Kemudian managing official AILA media seperti blog, Facebook and Instagram. Holding webinar or multi webinar tentang multimedia of language teaching and learning for teachers and lecturers. I think that's all. Itu terakhir apa masih ada ya, Pak? The next, apa ini terakhir? Okay, that's all. Okay. Itu saja programnya. Sekarang kita akan masuk ke sesi diskusi. Tapi ada satu sebelum masuk ke sesi diskusi tanya jawab mengenai program. Boleh mengusulkan, boleh bertanya, boleh menambahkan program yang ada. Atau Bapak Ibu yang belum masuk di dalam presentasi forum komunikasi ilmiah, silakan mendaftarkan dirinya di divisi research. Mungkin nanti di dalam grup AILA akan dimasukkan dalam deskripsi grup siapa saja yang masuk dalam board member di divisi masing-masing. Jadi langsung silakan kontak ke Bapak Ibu yang bertugas bertugas di bagian research. Ada satu isu yang akan kita tanyakan yaitu mengenai legalitas AILA ke depan. Apakah nanti kita akan bergerak menjadi sebuah legalized organization? Karena dengan legalized itu banyak sekali keuntungan yang bisa kita dapatkan. Mungkin Pak Giting bisa menambahkan.
Terima kasih Bapak Ibu sekalian. Terima kasih Bu Andini atas kesempatan yang sudah diberikan terkait dengan pertanyaan apakah nanti kita akan berbadan hukum? Iya. Jadi jawabannya adalah iya. Hanya kita harus bersabar bahwa untuk menuju ke sana ada satu proses yang harus kita lewati dulu. Kita harus mempersiapkan beberapa hal, begitu ya. Paling tidak kita harus ada satu kekompakan dulu ya di dalam. Kita melihat perkembangan yang ada ke depan seperti apa, begitu ya. Nah, kekompakan ini kan juga mengenai koordinasi untuk menyiapkan dokumen dan lain sebagainya, sehingga ketika nanti sudah harus diminta oleh notaris, kita sudah siap, gitu ya. Nah, tentunya karena AILA itu dari kita, untuk kita, dan oleh kita, sehingga apapun yang menjadi beban kita bersama, visi misi kita bersama, misalkan dalam konteks badan hukum nanti, ya, akan kita tanggung bersama-sama dalam banyak hal, begitu ya. Tetapi kita semua sepakat bahwa mari kita memulai dulu hal-hal yang berdampak, begitu ya. Sehingga dari itu nanti teman-teman di grup AILA gitu bisa melihat manfaatnya. Ya, tentunya sudah saya sampaikan tadi bahwa AILA ini akan menjadi rumah kita bersama. Rumah di mana nanti akan menjadi sebuah pendorong, Bapak Ibu ya, pendorong adanya satu perubahan pengembangan diri, ya harapannya seperti itu. Ke depan ada satu pengembangan yang bisa terukur, misalnya yang dulunya belum AA gitu ya, menjadi AA gitu, yang sudah AA menjadi lektor, gitu kan? Jadi lektor kepala, gitu. Nah, ini kan membutuhkan satu proses, ya, satu kerja, ya, yang mungkin akan lebih ringan bila kita tanggung bersama-sama, berkolaborasi, ya, gitu. Nah, kaitannya dengan ini, Ella akan memfasilitasi, ya. Ya, memang tidak semua jawaban bisa ditemukan di Ella, tetapi ada satu kemungkinan-kemungkinan yang bisa kita bantu nanti, ya. Nah, gitu harapan itu. Nah, terkait nanti Bapak Ibu, kita lihatlah ya perkembangan ke depan seperti apa, karena ada rencana dari pengurus Ella bahwa di dalam rangka untuk menjadi satu asosiasi yang berbadan hukum itu tidak hanya membutuhkan hal-hal sifatnya dokumen, tetapi juga hal-hal yang mengandung vitamin R, gitu ya, vitamin rupiah itu. Nah, tentunya nanti kita akan arahkan ke sana, tapi biarlah untuk yang ini nanti kita atur ya pelan-pelan begitu. Tapi kami yakin Bapak Ibu ya, artinya dengan sebuah modal sosial yang sudah kita bangun bersama begitu ya, nanti ini akan terwujud hasilnya ke depan. Nah, bagaimana kita bisa bisa mengarah ke sana, tentunya kan para peserta juga akan melihat ya kan sejauh mana Ella itu juga memberikan dampak kontribusi kepada pengembangan diri. Oleh karenanya kami akan menyusun program yang sifatnya reguler gitu ya, seperti forum komunikasi ilmiah gitu. Tetapi itu tidak itu saja. Kita akan juga memfasilitasi Bapak Ibu ya dengan kegiatan-kegiatan, misalkan oh saya ingin dibantu dong review artikel saya sedang ngurus AA atau saya sedang mengurus lektor kepala, tetapi bagaimana nih reviewnya artikelnya, kita bisa bantu Bapak Ibu ya. Jadi ada teman-teman yang sudah punya kepakatan sendiri nanti akan bisa membantu. Harapan saya seperti itu Bapak Ibu, Bu Andini gitu ya. Okay. Ya, makasih.
Terima kasih Pak Ginting. Ada satu saran lagi ini yaitu dari Pak Umar. Pak Umar suggest that Ella will make regional representative, whether they are provincial or city or agency representative.
Okay, Pak, that'll be great ya. Jadi harapannya ke depan nanti Ella akan mengarah ke sana, berkembang bahwa ada satu perwakilan begitu ya. Dari masing-masing lembaga. Dan itu memang kerinduan kita, keinginan kita ke depan itu. Karena pandemi ini, oleh karena kita agak sedikit dipaksa untuk seperti ini. Tetapi cita-cita kita bersama nanti kalau sudah pandemi is over, ya, kita akan adakan satu pertemuan yang sifatnya bisa kemana-mana. Ada yang dari Padang, gitu ya, ada yang dari Aceh, who knows, gitu ya. Nanti kita adakan sebuah kegiatan yang sifatnya reguler seperti itu. Nah, ya. Jadi jangan khawatir, nanti dari situ nanti akan tumbuh wakil-wakil kelembagaan ya. Tadi. Tapi dengan adanya satu grup WA, kemudian ada kepengurusan yang berbagai latar belakang ini, saya merasakan kehadiran secara kelembagaan itu sudah ada tentunya. Nah, tinggal memang kita harus betul-betul tidak hanya sampai di tataran ide saja, rencana saja, tetapi mengaktualisasikannya. Nah itu tadi ya, kalau sudah ngomong aktualisasi berarti ada motivasi diri, yuk kita mulai melakukan sesuatu. Nah itu yang lebih menantang saya rasa begitu ya Bu Andini.
Oke, terima kasih. Ada lagi saran dari Bapak Ibu, silahkan, ini saatnya diskusi, saran pendapat atau apapun demi perbaikan dan kemajuan kita ke depan. Ada lagi?
Bu Andini, boleh saya
ya. Sedikit? Iya, silakan Bu.
Tadi ada kegiatan yang sudah direncanakan dari bulan ke bulan di tahun 2021.
Ya.
Di grup WA kita, saya belum melihat itu, nanti mungkin bisa di share ya Bu Andini ya.
Oh, Bu Rahmi belum mengisi ya?
Oh, belum ya? Iya belum.
Berarti apa baru masuk ya Bu? Ibu baru masuk?
mungkin.
Oh ya.
Tapi soalnya ya forum komunitas itu saya memang mungkin belum bagian dari itu barangkali ya.
Waktu ada enggak Ibu ngisi Google Form waktu itu? Kan ada apa di Google Form? Pak Fahmi kayaknya sampai berapa kali itu, Pak?
Sudah, saya sudah ngisi satu Google Form yang di-share di WA.
Tapi nama Ibu enggak masuk ya?
Iya.
Belum masuk. Ya. Oke, enggak apa-apa. Ibu kira-kira bersidangnya bulan apa?
Saya itu malah belum tahu itu apa. Yang tadi ya, yang disebutkan oleh Bu Andini ya.
Iya, jadi apa, forum.
Anytime, Bu, bisa di... Tapi jangan Januari, bisa Februari seterusnya.
Oke. Nah, terima kasih, Bu.
Sama-sama.
Atau saya cari bulan yang sedikit pesertanya, maksudnya bukan peserta, speakernya di situ, boleh?
Tidak apa-apa, Bu, nggak apa-apa. Okay. Yang penting kita saling share aja dan bisa bermanfaat buat semua.
Ya. Jadi terima kasih, Bu. Jadi Bapak Ibu jangan takut forum komunikasi ilmiah tuh langsung kesannya bahwa aduh saya harus presentasi yang terlalu sangat expert gitu kan. Apapun boleh sharing knowledge yang saya tahu, silakan di-sharing untuk menambah. Yang kedua, masih planning research silakan. Mengajak saya planning research ini mungkin yang tertarik atau silakan join dengan saya silakan. Mau diseminasi hasil penelitiannya silakan. Apapunlah yang bisa di-share yang sifatnya ilmiah. Itu saja sih basic thing yang bisa dipegang Bapak itu.
Ya, Bu Andini, like what Bu Rahmi mentions before, Bu Rahmi offer in the chat that she has a proposal in terms of research EFL students collaborations. Oh. So Bu Rahmi may express this proposal in the forum, like what Pak Daniel Ginting has done before. Pak Daniel Ginting invite members to join book collaborations, writing book. And then maybe you can also offer this in the forum, in our forum. So I'm sure many of members will respond this positively for those who are in line with your research, Ibu.
Yeah. Okay. Atau mungkin kita bisa lihat di Februari ya. Saya offer dulu di Februari ada berapa orang. Yang pasti Bu Hikmah, Kak. Dan saya tanya yang lain lagi. Kalau bisa 3 orang, memang kita harapkan 3 orang untuk Februari. Okay. Terima kasih, Bu.
Iya, Bu Andini, saya baru saja share my interest dan planning untuk melakukan research. Sudah ada 2 orang yang tertarik, yaitu Bu Sri Ayu sama Bu Ella. Alhamdulillah, saya benar-benar amazed kepada grup ini. Malam ini aja kita sudah dapat 2 yang tertarik untuk bersama-sama. Wah, saya happy banget. Jadi saya sangat semangat. Terima kasih banyak semuanya.
Oke, itu yang kita lakukan bahwa kita bersama-sama maju. Maju bersama itu lebih indah daripada maju sendirian. Kalau sendirian kasihan, udah di depan, nggak ada kawannya, ujungnya kesepian kan gitu. Oke, silahkan yang lain Bapak Ibu. Ini saatnya kita mendengar voices, suara-suara dari Bapak dan Ibu.
I said from rakyat.
Iya, kita semua rakyat kan?
Yovani, Bu Andini.
Oke. Yang lain Bapak dan Ibu? Kalau malu boleh di-chat.
How about the project of the research? Has it been explained?
Project of the research
for across the year. I mean the programs that the research division gonna have this year.
Mungkin kita bisa dengar langsung dari Bapak Ibu di divisi research, Ibu Feni. Silakan please, Bapak Ibu. Please. Karena saya hanya menuliskan. Bapak Ibu. Halo. Ya? Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello?
Well, who's no? I think wants to talk. Okay.
Can you hear me? Hello, hello.
Hello?
Hello. Yeah?
Yeah. Ya, silakan Ibu. Halo.
Kita jelaskannya lebih bagus dengan bahasa Indonesia ya.
Oh, that's okay. Nanti daripada salah ada persepsi ya.
Ibu kan dan jadi salah persepsi. Oke, untuk program
minum ya, sorry.
Berdasarkan meeting, berdasarkan keyboard meta, adanya kan kolaborasi yang pertama research antara sesuatu yang sudah disarankan tadi, siapa yang berniat mengerjakan sesuatu program, silakan ditampilkan di grup nanti mungkin. Kedua yang juga menjadi apa ya di divisi research adalah coaching klinik ya. Saya dosen junior di IAIN Langsa, saya sekarang di Aceh. Saya baru lulus menjadi dosen sekitar 2 tahunan. Bon. Jadi kami memang masih sangat junior dan berharap di Pak Ginting, ada Pak Jasmansyah dan banyak sekali ya saya lihat memang senior yang jurnalnya sudah sampai Scopus kan, sudah bagus. Jadi kami berharap ada coaching klinik di mana nanti nyapir coaching atau bentuk seperti workshop. Setelah kita melaksanakan research, cara menulisnya seperti apa? Saya tahu banyak kita yang sudah mengerjakan research, sudah kemudian nulisnya yang susah untuk masuk atau tembus terindeks Scopus atau minimal yang Sinta 1-2 seperti itu. Dan ada juga yang menawarkan research grant. Karena memang di luar negeri kan banyak sekali hanya research grant yang dari Dikti atau dari kampus lembaga yang dari pemerintah.
Ya, koneksinya hilang, Bu Husnul.
Mungkin divisi research lain selain Bu Husnul ada lagi enggak?
Halo, halo.
Oh ya.
Mungkin ada Bu Mei, Pak Winarno, ada tidak?
Kayaknya ada lah.
Atau suara saya terdengar?
Sudah, Bu. You are back.
Oke, okay. Saya off. Off aja videonya ya. Jadi ada tentang research grant. Research grant maksudnya supaya anggota dari bukan divisi research sih, semua anggota AILA ini bisa mendapatkan grant. Nah, untuk grant research itu kan kita butuh yang bagus. Nah, mungkin banyak di sini dosen-dosen senior yang sudah pernah bisa melakukan coaching klinik kepada kami-kami yang junior. Dan juga ada tentang yang menawarkan tentang penulisan buku materi pembelajaran bahasa Inggris. Nah, mungkin seperti yang Pak Ginting sudah sarankan. Jadi, siapa yang mungkin berminat bikin book chapter, karena otomatis kan chapter seperti itu, nanti silahkan menawarkan diri, kita bakalan bahas kira-kira mau topiknya apa. Dan yang awal disepakati ada four wheel tadi, seperti kata Bu Andini, mungkin ini bakalan menjadi divisi research, di mana setiap peserta anggota AILA ini berhak menjadi presenter, bisa menjadi moderator, atau bahkan kalau mau coba-coba belajar dulu bisa juga menjadi, kita tahu, menjadi presenter, menjadi moderator, itu sebagai dosen kita terhitung dalam KUM, ya, misal dapatkan KUM, itu dihitung. Jadi sebenarnya banyak sekali yang sama-sama kita bisa raih di AILA ini. Dan seperti contoh, divisi riset saja bisa dari GAM, dan saya dari Aceh, Bu Meiza dari Padang, dan mungkin sekilas itu yang saya paparkan dari kawan-kawan di divisi research tentang kita. Mungkin dari Bapak Ibu yang ingin memberikan masukan bisa langsung grup nanti jika memang di sini belum ada ide, mungkin tutup forum kita, webinar kita, kemudian ada ide silahkan. Jadi kita untuk kita jadikan program-program lanjut si research. Mungkin Bu Adini sekian dari saya.
Oke, terima kasih Bu Husnul. Mungkin nanti Bu Husnul bisa melihat data siapa saja yang sudah Scopus, kemudian Bapak Ibu yang sudah
Scopus.
Sudah publikasi di Scopus, kemudian Bapak Ibu yang sudah mendapatkan gelar doktor, itu kan ilmunya juga cukup banyak yang bisa di-sharing kepada kita-kita yang masih merangkak-merangkak di bidang penelitian ini.
Ya, supaya Ibu ini boleh nambah?
Ya.
Ini barusan ada dari Pak Ahmad dan Pak Umar ya. Jadi yang mengenai untuk beasiswa ke luar negeri, kebetulan banyak teman-teman kita from this forum ini overseas graduate ya, kayak Bu Nindi ya, Bu Nining dan Bu Andini sendiri. Jadi nanti kita mengakomodir sesi sharing pertanyaan dan jawaban yang kita jabarkan ketika kita mendapatkan beasiswa Australia Award, LPDP, dan Mora, dan kita juga ada Mora ya di sini, Mora Awardis, Pak Nazir ya. Okay. Jadi nanti kita ada satu sharing yang di semua yang pernah mendapatkan beasiswa untuk berbagi sesi interview dan jawaban apa yang kita utarakan based on our context yang pernah kita jabarkan di dalam sesi interview waktu scholarship dulu. Ini bagi saya sangat bermanfaat ya, karena saya mengalami sendiri. Saya dulu juga bisa dapat beasiswa itu karena contekan-contekan. Dapat contekan dari teman-teman sebelumnya. Dan saya selalu mengikuti sharing scholarship sharing sessions, dan itu sangat really beneficial ya. Bu Nindia, Bu Nining, Bu Andini, dan ya, jadi kita bisa dari berbagai beasiswa, LPDP, Mora, Australia Award, jadi kita gabung jadi satu, nanti teman-teman yang lain, tahun ini kan ini Januari, kita harus agak cepat, karena LPDP itu buka tuh Juni, nggak tahu kalau Mora ya. Jadi preparation itu based on my experience cannot be done 1 month earlier. Kalau 1 month earlier itu you will get heart attack absolutely. Jadi itu harus one semester in advance itu udah prepare anything karena banyak sekali persyaratannya. Jadi kalau misalnya satu bulan itu nggak tercukup. Jadi mungkin nanti ada kita agendakan Februari atau Maret teman-teman udah yang pernah dapat beasiswa. Persiapkan, ingat lagi, retrieve your memory, what the question that have ever you got during the interview session, Bu Nindya, Bu Andini, Bu Nini, me, myself, and other
you're very members. Penny.
Yes? Yes.
Sorry to interrupt you for
yes?
Mungkin yang berbagi itu yang udah S3 ke luar negeri kali ini.
Yang S2 dulu juga nggak apa-apa, Bu Nining kan pernah dulu S2 Australia Award, dapat pertanyaannya apa. Jangan gitu, Bu Nining, you should share.
Itu yang lebih lebih apa sih namanya?
Nama up to date. Up to date.
Ya, lebih betul, linear.
Karena kita kan
yang linear dengan S3.
Mungkin yang up to date dan linear ke S3 kan.
Atau di dalam negeri juga yang selama proyek beasiswa itu boleh share ke kita. That's
it. Iya, tapi yang S2 juga lah, masa sendirian enggak enak. Rame-rame lebih asik. Karena pertanyaan dari pertanyaan yang Bu Nindya dapatkan, Bu Nining dapatkan mungkin muncul pada saat wawancara nanti. Dan Bu Andini juga. Bisa jadi kan pertanyaannya. Kadang seperti itu sih. Cuma emang kalau S3 emang beda sih. Saya melihat ada some questions a bit different from master degree. Lebih challenging. Tapi nggak ada salahnya Bu Andini, Bu Nining, dan Bu Nidia juga join. Mungkin pertanyaannya ada yang mirip-mirip.
Oke, mungkin bisa kita organize untuk webinar khusus kata Pak Fahmi tentang scholarship. Ya, jadi anything that can improve professional developments itu akan kita fasilitasi. Seperti apa tadi tiga yang disebutkan Pak Fahmi itu? Diakomodir, di apa saya lupa. Itu gender Ayla. Oke. Silakan Bapak Ibu yang lain.
Barangkali itu jadi ini ya, jadi webinar series ya nantinya untuk scholarship bisa jadi webinar series. Jadi mungkin tidak hanya satu kegiatan saja, tetapi bisa bersambung ke beberapa activity lagi ya.
Oke.
Okay. Itu bisa di, jadi webinar series siapa-siapa nanti yang jadi pembicaranya ya. Jadi kayak bincang santai. Okay. Jadi biar yang S2 juga nggak begitu gimana gitu kan yang dapat.
Iya. Yeah. Ya. Santai dapat santai sertifikat loh.
Iya, betul.
BKD, BKD. Ginting tuh ketua BKD Pak Ginting buat pusing.
Sebenarnya gini, as a few months ago saya itu ada initiated introduce my supervisor ya ke STAI Asanta Jambi. And her presentation is absolutely excellent. Saya juga saya sampai itu bilang I wish I could start my doctorate degree after listening her delivery, you know, her presentations. Karena di situ beliau menjelaskan dengan detail what is a doctorate degree proposal like, the standard one. Jadi harusnya the standardized one. Jadi apa minimal ini gimana, ini harus apa yang diisi, poinnya apa aja, dan it's around 2,000 words. Jadi enggak, itu rinci banget. Jadi kalau mau, boleh saya invite supervisor saya, tapi make sure kalau kita kalau saya invite supervisor saya, make sure kita udah punya website. Kalau nanti dia nanya mana websitenya, aduh nanti saya tahu gitu. Jadi kita punya website dulu. Nah, jadi karena beliau itu kalau kita undang tuh pastinya tuh udah lihat dulu ini institusinya apa. Maksudnya karena dia kan juga on behalf of her institute ya, jadi dia juga bikin laporan kalau dia tuh ada presentasi gitu, ini websitenya kayak gitu. Jadi kalau misalkan berkenan, nanti boleh saya undang Dr. Aisling, supervisor saya, beliau juga direktur international relationship. Jadi tugas dia kan, jadi dia senang sekali kalau being invited by us, but make sure that we have a website already because before presenting usually she learn what is our association like. Jadi she try to adjust with our association. Maybe later, maybe in the beginning or our about presentation about the scholarships, but later on maybe in June or July. About,
like a series kan? Pertama scholarship, kemudian proposal.
Yes. That's it. Yes, that's true. Yeah, that's what like Bu Deli said.
Tim IT, karena berhubungan dengan tim IT, bagaimana kesiapan dengan website? Karena ternyata website itu penting juga ya. Jika kita ingin mengundang
sangat penting.
Kenapa Penny? Dia perlu
it should be in English ya, and it should be in English. I learn a lot when I introduced before I was the ambassador of Queen's University Belfast and I was paid for that at that time but now I resign already. So jadi I introduce some schools in Indonesia, international schools, and also and I even invited Queen's University Belfast come to Semarang on my intention to connect to bridge the communication between Indonesia and UK at that time. And then they learn from the website first. And I said, oh, okay. And then when they also try to come to Tanjung Pura University, they also ask, is there any English versions of the website, Miss Veni? And I said, oh my good bro. I said, oh my God, I'm assuming because our website is in Indonesian. So that's it's true that they really want to know what is our institutions like. Mm-hmm. Because that's the standard for them to approach whether there is a potential connection or potential cooperation in the future. So for your information, like my university already has a very close connection with University of Indonesia, UI, because UI is really good in approaching collaboration with international institutions. And their website also in English already. So it's easier as well for international institution to approach them because they provide for detailed information in English. Jadi kalau bisa nanti Ila, our website should be in English as well. Okay. Gitu Bu Andi.
Ini ada apa? Ada pertanyaan ini Bu Andi dari Bu Rahmi. barangkali nanti post kembali ya untuk divisi-divisinya ya, kepengurusan di WA grup yang umum, bukan yang di board ya, member board.
Rencana mungkin nanti bisa, masuk di deskripsi grup aja Bu, jadi mereka bisa lihat.
Iya, iya, betul. Nanti jadi bisa Feni tahu bisa mereka harus menghubungi siapa gitu.
Iya. Bu Feni nanti mungkin masukkan di deskripsi grup, jadi enak kan, nggak mesti scroll-scroll, jadi lihat deskripsi langsung.
Boleh, ya, ya, nanti di. Oh, ya benar. Oh, ini juga misalnya untuk nanti untuk beasiswa, sharing beasiswa, itu teman saya banyak sekali dari Mora di sini, jadi akan saya undang mereka, saya paksa mereka undang ke sini. Harus mereka presentasi. Teman-teman yang suka, karena banyak di sini Mora ya, jadi kita harusnya approach them to open the secret, what are the questions and what are the answers. Jadi jawaban mereka seperti apa? Jadi kita bisa nyontek-nyontek.
Ini sudah menarik sekali ya, Bu Feni, Bu Andini, sudah sampai sebegininya proses yang sudah kita lewati bersama ya. Ini sangat menarik. Kenapa? Karena kita baru mungkin sebulan ya intensitas kita ngobrol ya di WA Group, dan kita sudah mengeksekusi satu program. Yeah. Jadi kedepannya ya pasti akan banyak lagi program-program yang tentu saja akan sangat memberikan benefit untuk kita semua. Ya barangkali kita langsung bisa apa ya, mengenai cost sepertinya harus segera kita sepakati mungkin malam ini, karena ya banyak yang sudah hadir di sini. Apakah kita perlu seperti yang sudah sempat kita ngobrol-ngobrol ya? Gimana Bu Feni?
Oh, donasi.
Apa kira-kira harus di-announce kah itu? Karena kan ya kita sudah menawarkan istilahnya banyak hal, dan kita sudah menunjukkan bahwa kita sudah sama-sama punya komitmen untuk Ayla ke depan ya, seperti apa. Barangkali ini kan ada cost, jadi kita harus share ya, sharing cost-nya. Kemudian satu lagi tambahan, mungkin website memang ada biaya juga, ada cost-nya. Jadi barangkali mungkin di tim IT, kalau mau yang free tentu saja pakai Blogspot ya, mungkin yang untuk sementara yang website yang free ya, mungkin pakai Blogspot boleh juga itu ya. Kemudian ada official YouTube yang bisa ya, jadi kegiatan-kegiatan seperti ini bisa dilihat di YouTube. Jadi YouTube official milik dari Ayla ya, jadi ke depan. Jadi bisa orang nanti kan nyari kita share, mereka bisa lihat sudah seperti apa kegiatan yang dilaksanakan oleh Ayla. Barangkali itu saya cuma mengingatkan ya, terima kasih.
Mungkin mengenai website, nah saya akan tanya suami saya, karena suami saya itu punya domain sendiri. Jadi mungkin apa masih? Nanti saya tanya. Jadi ya biasanya tuh murah sekali sih dia, cuma $1-2 biasanya gitu.
Itu pun nggak masih. Keren, keren.
Nanti saya tanya masih apa enggak? Soalnya kemarin-kemarin biasanya saya numpang dia, punya dia punya. Oke. Kemudian, oh ya, mohon maaf, saya ketinggalan ini memaparkan program dari Test and Translation Division. Mohon maaf, Bapak dan Ibu di Test and Translation Division. Jadi program dari Test and Translation Division adalah peningkatan penerjemahan terlisensi, kemudian pembentukan komunitas penerjemah terlisensi. Wow, mudah-mudahan ada pelatihannya ya. Sharing pengalaman tes internasional, scholarship atau standardized test. Oh, jadi mungkin nanti webinarnya di under divisi ini maunya. Kolaborasi pelatihan dan peningkatan kemampuan tes internasional, workshop penerjemah langsung dan tidak langsung. Oh, saya mau ikut ini. 6, karena saya ngajar mata kuliah ini dan saya tidak ada ilmu sebenarnya, tapi dipaksa harus ngajar. 6, workshop peningkatan skor IELTS, TOEFL, and TOEIC. 7, meningkatkan standardized test online. Oke, itu adalah program kerja dari divisi test dan translation. Oke, ada lagi Bapak dan Ibu?
About the funding, Bu Andini.
Banding, mungkin kita ke Pak Ginting bagaimana Pak? Dua ibu mendesak untuk diumumkan funding.
Donation, we call it donation.
Ya. Bu Andini itu pinter sekali kalau ada isu begini Pak Ginting. Ketawanya paling keras ini Bu Andi. Oke, sebelum mengarah ke funding, saya agak mau memberikan komentar ya. Jadi Bapak Ibu, AILA ini, asosiasi kita ini itu adalah bersifat volunteer ya. Jadi sifatnya sukarela. Tetapi dari sisi sukarela begitu ya, Bapak Ibu tahu, sukarela itu berarti kan bahwa niat itu datang dari di dalam hati begitu ya. Jadi muncul karena ada satu keinginan, sesuatu yang tidak dipaksa, tetapi memang atas kesadaran. Nah, ini jadi saya, apa namanya, saya takjub gitu ya. Artinya takjubnya itu engagement-nya cukup tinggi. Engagement itu adalah adanya satu interaksi yang cukup intens. Kita lihat misalkan tadi programnya Bu Andini tadi. Ya, sudah mulai bulan Januari ya Bu Andini ya.
Iya.
Sampai bulan Desember ini kan engagement-nya sangat tinggi ini ya. Sebuah grup yang baru ya. Sudah ada nama-nama sudah tertulis sana ya Bu ya. Tinggal nanti mungkin lebih dispesifikkan lagi. Tanggalnya berapa begitu ya, dan temanya harus lebih spesifik. Karena tadi sudah ada banyak masukan ya kan, ketika Bu Feni ngomong beasiswa, waduh langsung blar gitu tadi chatnya langsung blar, semangat begitu ya, luar biasa. Sehingga nanti harus dispesifikkan, karena tadi yang sudah berharap-harap untuk beasiswa tidak kehilangan momen ini. Nah, sehingga harus dispesifikkan tanggalnya. Nah, kemudian juga ngomong tentang research proposal itu bagus sekali ya, khususnya teman-teman yang sudah pengalaman juga untuk itu. Kemudian sekali lagi nanti kan ada jadwal untuk Forkomil ya Bu ya, Forum Komunikasi Ilmiah gitu ya. Jadi Bapak Ibu yang sudah punya rencana riset atau sedang melakukan riset dan ingin menawarkan kegiatan ini untuk dikolaborasikan, itu adalah wadah yang bagus untuk menyuarakan selain disampaikan di grup WA. Kan begitu. Kalau dipaparkan kan tahu substansinya. Jadi bagus. Jadi nanti bisa mengisi ruang-ruang kosong yang di mana di bagian riset tadi. Kemudian untuk penerjemahan yang bersertifikasi itu bagus sekali. Kemudian juga mengenai language testing itu juga sangat bagus. Nah, sekarang tiba saatnya untuk soal pendanaan ya. Jadi harus ada introduction-nya kan. Orang Indonesia kan muter-muter dulu baru sampai ke substansi. Nah, baik. Bapak Ibu, terkait tentang pembiayaan, memang mau enggak mau kita harus berbicara tentang mau yang dibiayai itu apa, begitu ya. Kalau ngomong yang dibiayai apa, berarti kan kita ngomong mana yang urgent, ya. Yang urgent itu bisa short term dan long term. Ya. Kalau yang short term itu pasti kita bicara tentang Zoom, ya kan? Nah, untuk link Zoom ini saya berterima kasih secara pribadi dan juga teman-teman pengurus kepada Dr. Jasmansyah ini. Ya. Ini linknya gratis Bapak Ibu. Ya, link gratis kita bisa pakai berjam-jam. Matur nuwun, Pak Jas. Namun ya kita tidak bisa terus-menerus merepotkan Pak Jas. Sehingga tentunya kita harus membebankan biaya itu untuk ini. Itu yang long term. Dan kita tahu mulai bulan Januari sampai Desember ya Bu Andini ya, sudah penuh ya Bu ya. Yeah. Yang banyak ngisi ya. Nah, tentu untuk pembiayaan yang sifatnya short term itu harus ke sana. Nah, kalau mengenai website, selagi masih ada blogspot atau WordPress, ya mungkin bisa kita lah ya menggunakan itu dulu yang mungkin masih bisa bisa kita manfaatkan dengan dampak yang kita harapkan. Misalkan kita akan mau mengepul informasi di sana begitu ya. Misalkan informasi-informasi yang terkait dengan ELA, kegiatannya akan datang dan sebagainya. Sampai nantinya kita bisa punya uang untuk buat server sendiri seperti suaminya Bu Andini. Syukur-syukur nanti kita punya server, kita buat OJS. Buat jurnal sendiri gitu ya. Tapi kan itu masih jauh Bapak Ibu. Ya. Tapi misalkan kalau website ya kita gunakan yang gratisan dulu saja. Nah, yang long term ini, nah kalau kita punya satu keinginan untuk menjadikan ini jadi berbadan hukum, itu angkanya sudah kelihatan 5 juta di depan notaris Bapak Ibu. Jadi saya dengar begitu. Ya mungkin saya salah, tapi mungkin bisa dikoreksi gitu ya. Itu sekitar 5 juta di notaris. Nah, kalau kita menganggap ini sebagai satu kegiatan dari kita, untuk kita, oleh kita, nah, mungkin kita tanggung bersama-sama begitu. Tapi Bapak-Ibu, saya mengusulkan, mungkin kita lakukan secara berproses dulu. Jadi biarlah teman-teman dari peserta gitu ya, yang ada di WA Group merasakan dulu. Jadi merasakan dampak kegiatan kita dulu, sehingga akhirnya mereka merasa, oh ada satu trust gitu kan, puas, baru nanti kita akan arahkan kepada donasi untuk keanggotaan. Nah, kapan itu? Mungkin kita bisa lakukan. Kita lihat dulu evaluasinya. Kalau memang engagement-nya tinggi, bulan pertama oke, bulan kedua oke, bulan ketiga, ya mungkin mulai bulan ketiga. Misalnya begitu. Jadi tidak langsung gitu. Biar kita awali dulu, sambil kita evaluasi. Berapa nanti kita bisa rundingkan. Saya rasa begitu ya. Terima kasih.
Oke, jadi silakan Bapak Ibu yang memikirkan jika merasa organisasi ini membuat memberikan banyak benefit ke depan, silakan menyisihkan sedikit uang yang ada untuk membantu keberlangsungan dari organisasi ini. Ya. Oke, saya rasa itu adalah
ya Bu. Bu Andri, barangkali nanti ke depan mungkin kalau misalnya bulan ketiga, sebenarnya kalau Pak Gindo sudah mempertimbangkan hal tersebut tidak masalah. Cuman kita juga perlu juga menyampaikan bahwa kalau kita sudah menyatakan ikut dengan kegiatan Ayla ini, jadi menjadi Ayla member itu semacam dana atau dana loyalitas lah. Dengan demikian maka setiap kegiatan Ayla itu kan free, semuanya free karena sudah menjadi sudah menyatakan loyalitas melalui dana tersebut. Ya mungkin nanti kita sepakati bersama. Jadi misalnya dalam satu semester free terus. Jadi ada kegiatan Ayla itu dia free terus, mau workshop, mau webinar series ya, atau ada apa itu dia free di kegiatan yang seperti ini contohnya ya. Jadi nanti mungkin kita sampaikan ke member yang lain yang barangkali masih belum interest, mungkin kita sampaikan announce ini lagi ya. Barangkali dari Bu Feni juga yang semangat ya untuk menyampaikan. Jadi timbal balik dari menyampaikan loyalitas itu adalah dia masing-masing member itu free untuk kegiatan atau program yang dilaksanakan oleh Ayla. Barangkali itu yang bisa saya tambahkan. Bagaimana Bu Feni?
Ya, setuju Ibu Deli. Jadi donation ini will not be a burden for you, everyone. It's only once in a year. So every 1st of January we announce that. So to rememorize our inauguration. Jadi setiap tahun nanti kita akan, pokoknya setiap tahun ada donasi dan itu hanya cuma sekali, only once in a year. Anggap itu amal jariah ya. Enggak berkurang rezeki kalau sedekah. Terus yang kedua itu based on our capacity. Seberapa banyak pun itu we will welcome in any amount of money we have. Jadi itu like investment for your dedication and also investment for yourself in the future ya. Terus kita juga di ILA ini juga akan memberikan sertifikat bagi Bapak dan Ibu untuk misalnya PKM. Kita kan akan ada PKM, jadi semua bisa berhak untuk menjadi moderator, semua berhak menjadi presenter untuk sharing penelitiannya. Jadi kita akan ada dalam bentuk sertifikat dan itu Bapak dan Ibu bisa gunakan untuk pengisian BKD. Bapak dan Ibu bisa buat proposal sendiri di kampus, kolaborasi PKM. Misalnya, oh saya buat kolaborasi PKM dengan Pak Daniel, Bu Sylvia, Bu Deli, universitas ini, universitas ini. And I'm sure your university, your institute will be amazed with your connection. Karena it's not easy to find, to build such kind of huge network ya, particularly in Indonesia, yang kalau kayak gini nih udah enhance our accreditations and your boss, your superior prodi. Will yeah, prodi, let's say prodi, your boss ya, your prodi will say, you have a connection, okay, let introduce us with your colleagues, nanti akan minta diperkenalkan untuk extend the network, not only your prodi, but other prodi too. Jadi kan makin berkembang. Jadi dengan ini, koneksi yang ditawarkan ILA ini really, really beneficial ya, it's really worth it. Nggak ada lagi lah saya melihat di asosiasi di Indonesia yang semeriah ini, se-equal ini, everybody can have your voice. Nggak ada yang up, nggak ada yang bawah, semuanya sama. Nggak ada merasa feeling apa, feel inferior in any society, in many respects, kita semua equal. Jadi jika bapak dan ibu di kampusnya memiliki kesulitan dalam mengadakan PKM atau tergantung dengan institusi yang agak geraknya lamban, ibu dan bisa empower yourself, mengajukan ke tim saya mau bikin proposal tentang PKM, siapa aja yang mau? Oke, oh bulan ini kita. Oke, jadi ibu bikin proposal sendiri untuk di kampus, sebutkan nama-nama teman-teman yang mau PKM di bulan ini, PKM-nya, dan kita bersedia menjadi pendengar, dan ada institusi yang lain yang bersedia menunjukkan tanda tangan. So, what can you expect more than this, guys? Jadi saya rasa ini nih udah benar-benar really worth it ya. Jadi saya senang sekali to be a member of ILA. Thank you so much Pak Daniel Ginting and other colleagues because you are so awesome. Saya merasa feeling proud to be here.
Wah, luar biasa PR-nya ini.
Oke.
Okay. Jadi kesimpulannya Bu Andini, Oke, nanti kita akan ke depan akan mengarah ke bagian donasi tadi, tapi coba kita jalan dulu sambil nanti kita evaluasi. Gitu aja ya. Jadi kapannya mohon nanti kita rapat dulu, dibuat dulu ya. Itu ya Bu Feni ya. Enggak apa-apa ya.
Sip, Pak. Nanti saya bisa menyampaikannya di grup dengan in a very gentle way.
Oke, terima kasih.
Oke, terima kasih Bapak Ibu. Saya rasa beberapa kata dari Pak Ginting menutup webinar kita pada hari ini, inaugurasi kita pada hari ini. Boleh saya sampaikan, simpulkan bahwa hari ini kita telah melaksanakan webinar diawali dengan pemaparan logo dengan begitu syarat makna dari Pak Fahmi, yang mungkin memikirkannya begitu detail sampai berada dalam
setiap Bu Andini ya. Mohon maaf interupsi sedikit, ini di chat room ada Pak Umar. Ada Pak Umar menyampaikan sesuatu, mungkin boleh di ini.
Oh, Pak Umar. Okay. Pak Umar, I was offered a membership in a lecture organization, that is a registration fee. It can be applied or we can share annually, monthly fee, I don't mind. The amount can be discussed. Okay, sudah dapat positif respon. Okay. Nah, positif respon dari Bu Feni, jualannya laku tuh. Okay.
Dini, okay. There is a message from Bu Ainu regarding the attendance list to get a certificate for today's conference.
Okay, Bapak Ibu silakan lihat link yang diberikan oleh Bu Ainu, tim IT, jika Bapak Ibu ingin mendapatkan sertifikat untuk kehadiran. Lumayan tahun hari pertama di tahun 2021 kita sudah siap satu hal untuk mengisi BKD atau SKP. Wah, ini bagusnya Ayla nih mengawali dengan sebuah sertifikat yang akan menolong kita di hal-hal administrasi, bukan hanya di dalam keilmuan juga ya. Oke, silakan Bapak Ibu bisa diklik nanti.
Is it okay if we click this after the sessions? That's fine, right?
I don't know. Mungkin ada waktu jangkanya. Hah? It's okay ya?
Yeah, I think that's fine.
Biasanya ada tenggat waktunya biasanya, tapi enggak tahu yang ini.
Mungkin kalau dia batas waktunya ada, tapi kalau tidak dia masih bisa sepanjang linknya masih ada.
Ah, oh, sip. Ada
sip. Kita
mungkin bisa di share di chat.
Iya.
Di grup WA ya, Bu.
Yes. Yes. Bu Ainu mungkin di grup WA bisa.
Ya, Bu Aini mungkin ini Pak Jasmansah. Kenapa ini? Minta link. Oh, Pak Jasmansah minta link. Oke, nanti di-share kembali di grup. Karena ini otomatis ya, karena yang enggak hadir enggak dapat attendance kan?
Biasanya kalau udah close nggak bisa lagi diklik linknya.
Automatically ya. Ya atau misalnya linknya karena ini the first time ya yeah, for our conference that we give waiver to anyone who although not attend so they can they are entitled okay. to the certificate. That's okay. Yeah. So, with a big discount yeah. for today.
Mm-hmm. Ya, nggak tahu nih ya, si IT-nya nyetingnya seperti apa gitu.
Ya, so team IT, could you share it in WA group for the whole members ya of AILA.
Jadi yang nggak ikut conference, yang nggak ikut pun nggak masalah ya untuk hari ini. Jadi karena kita juga baru belajar kan.
Bu yes. Bu Feni bisa nanti minta PPT-nya Bu Fatimah nggak?
I will ask her after this.
Mungkin bisa di share di grup Ayla, ya? Yeah.
Yes, we will. Thank you, Bu.
Bu Andini, karena Pak. Hari ini kan direkam begitu ya, nanti rekamannya bisa di upload begitu di satu akun YouTube?
YouTube Pak, nanti kita bikin yeah. YouTube, kita bikin okay. YouTube account.
Okay, very good. Yes.
Kita kan sudah punya ini ya, Pak Ginting. Kita kan sudah punya email kan, sudah punya email. Ayla kan, iya. Jadi nanti
betul, betul.
Digunakan okay. email Ayla ya, akunnya itu.
Oke, okay. Tim IT, PR tim IT ini dua nih.
Iya. Maaf tim IT, ngerepotin terus.
Enggak apa-apa, Bu. Masih muda semua, Bu. Tenaga masih banyak.
Kita masih remaja kok, Bu Andini. Mereka muda, kita remaja.
Remaja, asisten ahli, Pak. Belum naik-naik lama.
Kakak kawan lah tuh ini. Banyak lo ceritanya tentang rumah tangga.
Oke, saya rasa saya akan menutup pertemuan kita hari ini.
Bentar,
Bu Andi.
Kawan lo udah WT kan?
Oh, belum foto ya? Sama ya.
Foto bersamanya belum.
Sebelum itu,
kita foto bersama dulu ya.
Oh, silakan Bapak Ibu menghidupkan videonya. Karena tolong kita akan foto diatur bersama.
Ini biar biar galerinya semua muncul. Tim IT tolong diatur biar semuanya galeri muncul ya.
Karena sudah semakin lama nanti banyak yang
Ya. Baik Ibu, mungkin untuk yang belum mengaktifkan videonya mau diaktifkan dulu. Ada dua page jadi mungkin nanti saya akan memandu untuk dokumentasinya. Sekitar beberapa kali, jadi disiapkan mungkin boleh berbagai gaya juga ya Bu?
Boleh.
Kameranya.
Ya, oke. Masih ada beberapa yang belum mengaktifkan video, atau kita lanjut saja ya Bu? Baik, kita mulai untuk dokumentasinya. 3, 2, 1. Ya, lagi. Untuk page selanjutnya, 3, 2, 1. Ya, sekali lagi. Oke.
Aduh, Bu. Tangan saya ketutup.
Buka. Oh ya, udah terakhir ya? Pakai 321.
Jadi saya nyengir.
Halo Bu Rahmi.
Halo Bu Rahmi baru muncul.
I see you.
Enggak pakai 321 saya nyengir aja tadi. Saya aja enggak tahu lagi diputo apa enggak.
Iya, Bu Andini kayaknya tegang sekali.
Saya enggak tahu foto apa enggak, ya udah. Karena kameranya juga enggak ngerti saya di mana, kok muka saya miring terus.
Ada ini di Mas Ridan ini, yang di IT.
Bisa di-share, Mas.
Iya, nanti di-share ya Mas Ridan di WA group ya fotonya. Ya,
nanti saya share di grup.
Ya Allah, masih muda benar, berapa umur? Ya. Saya mau bilang Pak enggak jadilah.
Nah, ini kayak anak saya yang paling besar loh, Mas Ridan.
Ibu Ainu juga masih muda banget.
Nah,
Ibu Ainu, Pak Ridan dengan Bu Nindya semuanya youngsters.
Iya ya.
Saya baru lulus ya Pak Ibu.
Oh, ya Allah. Oke. Okay. Bagus bagus. Harus ada.
Oke, kayaknya udah malam ya ini.
Ya, oke, okay. Kita tutup buat kayaknya saya enggak mau bikin kesimpulan lah, udah kayaknya udah malam. Nanti
thank lama you lagi. To everyone.
Jadi untuk yang board member, setelah ini kata Pak Gining jangan keluar dulu karena akan ada rapat sebentar mengenai evaluasi. Ya, yang menjadi board member kita belum tutup. Jadi terima kasih Bapak dan Ibu. Semoga semangat hari pertama ini akan terus kita pelihara sampai di akhir tahun depan, dan kita semangat untuk maju, semangat untuk berkolaborasi, dan semangat untuk terus menginspirasi satu sama lain. Karena inspirasi bukan hanya datang dari yang telah berpengalaman, tapi inspirasi juga bisa datang dari orang yang ingin maju.
Okay. Betul, betul.
Saja kata penutup dari saya. Thank you so much.
Thank you Bu Andini, Bu Feni.
Terima kasih.
Thank you everyone.
Thank you
Pak Ginting.
Thank you.
Thank you everyone.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam. Terima kasih.
Jangan keluar dulu ya.
Jangan lupa e-certificate.